We're in Eduyot, Perek Dalid Mishnah, fifth Mishnah, in the fourth chapter of the second Eduyot. So we're going to talk about Kerem Rabbi, but it's also the halacha of Neta Rabbi. And the only reason we say Kerem Rabbi is because in the end it says we're going to talk about Ololot and Peret and Ololot, which we'll describe what that is. But we're talking about Kerem Rabbi and Neta Rabbi, which means produce of the fourth year. So if you have a tree, well, these halachot are brought in by Yikra Perek Yud Gimel, Pasuk Chav Gimel, by Yikra Perek Yud Tem, sorry, 19, chapter 19. You come to the land of Israel and you plant any fruit trees. That's a halacha of orla. You shall count the fruit thereof as forbidden. 3 years, the first 3 years of a plant's life, of a tree's life, can't eat the fruit. And the fourth year, all the fruit thereof shall be holy, giving praise to God. So what do you do with this fourth? That's called Neta Rabbi, or Kerem Rabbi. We'll dedicate our learning to remembering my father, Rav Simcha Ben Yitzchak Kalman. Let's see, I'll just write it down. It's Kerem Rabbi, okay? We'll call it Kerem Rabbi. That's what we saw. Okay, the fourth year of a Kerem. A Kerem is a vineyard, or Neta Rabbi. That's normally, it's not from a Kerem, it's called Neta Rabbi Netiah. From the word planting, the plantings of the fourth year. It's all the same. Okay, so now the halacha is the following. What do you do in that fourth year? That fourth, what is it, when it says, we'll go back to the psukim, and it says, Kodesh Hilulim Lashem, we treat it like Maaser Sheni. Maaser Sheni. What do you do in Maaser Sheni? That's in Dvarim. Dvarim Perek. What chapter are we in? Chapter 9, 14. Yudalit. Okay, we learn Aser Taaser Kol Tvuat Azarecha. Yotzei Yisraeli Shana Shana. You shall surely tithe all the produce of your field. What do? You eat it before God. You take it to Yerushalayim, okay, and you eat it before Hashem. That's what you do with what's called Ma'aser Sheni. And Ma'aser Sheni, if you look at the Wikipedia page for Ma'aser Sheni, okay, it's what you do during the first, second, fourth, and fifth of the Shemitah years. You take a tenth, and you have to bring it to Yerushalayim. And if you can't bring it to Yerushalayim, we're going to do one more sukkim, one more pasuk. That's in Vayikra. We're in Vayikra Perek. Let's see what Perek we're in. Vayikra Perek Chavzayin. Vayikra Perek Chavzayin. Oops, shouldn't have done that. Okay. In Vayikra Perek Chavzayin, still recording? Yes, we are. Perek Chavzayin, it says, okay, Chol Ma'asar La'aretz Mizera Ha'aretz Mipri Aretz La'Hashem Hu Kodesh La'Hashem. It's for Kodesh. Let's say you can't bring this produce to Yerushalayim. You got Ma'aser Sheni, it's a ton of oranges. You want to redeem it. That's what everybody did. They would redeem it on money. Chamishito Yosef Alav. You have to add on a fifth. Meaning you can't just, when you transfer the value to the money, if I have $100, 100 shekel worth of oranges, I have to have 125 shekel. I have to add a chomesh. Okay, why is it 125? Because it's a chomesh, it's a fifth including. So it's really a quarter, right? It's external fit. Anyhow, so now, if you have Kerem Rabbah, we've learned that in Maaser, you have to do what's called, you have to have Chomesh, okay, in Maaser Sheni. And we know that just like Kerem Rabbah, just like Maaser Sheni, you have Pidiyah, your Podeh, and you eat in Yerushalayim. Okay, but we know in Maaser Sheni, you have to redeem it. And when you ever redeem it, you have to do a Chomesh. Okay. In addition, there's a halacha called biur. Okay, the biur of maaser. The Torah says explicitly you have to do at the end of the fourth year of Shmi'it, you have to do biarti hakodesh min habayit. There's biur maaserot. It's dvarim chavav. It's another pasuk. Okay. So let's make a little chart just because it's getting confused. In the magic of internet time, I was able to make this chart. So we have maaser sheni. We know the din. What's the din? You bring it to Yerushalayim to eat, right? On the during the second, third, fourth, and fifth years of Shemitah, or mechalalim al kesef shemibiim liyushalayim mikanod ochel, or you mechalal on money as the din of kedusha. Okay, neta and kerem ravai. That's the same halacha. Okay, the same halacha. You also bring it to Yerushalayim to eat, or you bring it on money. So now chomesh ubiur. Is there a halacha of chomesh and biur for Maaser Sheni? Yes. But the Torah says explicitly there is a halacha of chomesh and biur, meaning you have to add a fifth when you transfer the money. And during the fourth year, the seventh year of the Shemitah cycle, you have to say, I do biur. What about Karen Ravai. Do we, that's the Mishnah's question. Do, in this thing, in Neter Karen Ravai, is there a Chomesh and Bir or not? And that's the machloka between Beit Hillel and Beit Shammai. Remember, we're in the middle of learning these Mishnayot about the stringencies of Beit Hillel versus Beit Shammai. Karen Ravai. Beit Shammai omim ein lo chomesh ve'ein lo biur. Beit Shammai says there is no chomesh and there is no biur. Meaning when you transfer the money, when you transfer the money to money of Karen Ravai to take Yerushalayim, you don't have to add a fifth. Ve'ein lo biur, and you don't have to get rid of it during when you do biur ma'asrot. Look at the Bar Tanura. You know, chayav le'ba'aro min ha'bayit be'er pesach shereviyi v'shel shviyit. You don't have to do that. Whereas Beit Hillel says, Beit Hillel omim yesh lo chomesh ve'yesh lo biur. There also is Chomesh and Biur. Meaning, why does he say that? Okay, because Beit Hillel Yalfe Kodesh Kodesh Mimaser. It says Biarti HaKodesh Min HaBayit. So Maser is called Kodesh. And let's go back to the pasuk about that we learned about Neter Ravai. It says, okay, Chamishito. It says we're Kodesh LaHashem Kol Maaser MiPiaretu Kodesh LaHashem. Is that the one? No, that's not the one. We're in Yutet. We have to go to Yutet. I'm in the wrong one. Here we are. Here it says, Shana Revi'it, Kodesh Hilulim Lashem. Here it says Kodesh also. And so Beit Hillel says, it says Kodesh here, B'yarti Kodesh, and there it says Kodesh. Ma Ma'aser Yesh Lo Chomesh, Yesh Lo Bir. Just like Ma'aser is Chomesh and Bir. Av Kemer Ravai, Yesh Lo Chomesh and Yesh Lo Bir. So also Beit Hillel says, there is Kodesh and Bir for Kerem Ravai. Next halacha. Beit Shammai Omim Yesh Lo Peret. If we're talking about Kerem Ravai, and that's what the Mishnah talks about Kerem. Okay, there's a halacha called Peret and Olelot. These are also what's called Matnot Aniyim, gifts that go to the poor. Peret are the grapes that fall off. The grapes that fall off the cluster, they belong to the poor. Olelot, the grapes, these are the clusters that don't have the katef. They're misformed clusters. And the halacha is that you have to leave them for the poor. But what about parent and the olelot of the fourth year? Is it God's produce, and therefore all of God's produce I can take it? It's not mine, and therefore I don't have to leave it for the aniyim. Or is it my produce that I have in the halacha that I have to take it to Yerushalayim? So Beit Shammai says yesh lo parent yesh lo olelot. It's my produce, okay, and therefore I can't take it. But aniyim, they have to leave it for the poor. Aniyim podim lasmam, the poor people take it. It is the halacha of the fourth year. They redeem it and they bring it to Yerushalayim. Beit Hillel omrim, Beit Hillel says, no. Kulo lagat. It all goes into the gat, into the wine press. I.e., you bring it all, there's no peret and oh no olelot. Okay? And therefore, because he says, Bartender says, Svirlu Maaser Sheni Mamon Gavoahu. It belongs to Mamon Gavoah. We learned that it's Maaser, it's like Maaser. And just as Maaser Sheni belongs to God, so too, here too, this Karen Ravai belongs to God, and therefore I can take it all and don't leave it for the poor, and you can take it all and bring it all to Yerushalayim. Dedicate our learning? We'll do it again. Dedicate our learning to remember me and my father, Rav Simcha Ben Yitzchak Kalman. Have a great day.